the acting IG who has been in charge of this service over the last few months, and all the other officers who have supported the leadership of the National Police Service in making sure that there is continuity and there is clarity on the matters relating to the security of our country.
Ekonene. So one of the stories that ilikuwa na make headlines hapa Kenya on Thursday ilikuwa the story that Douglas Kanja amekuwa installed as the Inspector General of the National Police Service. And just before that, I think the previous day, kulikuwa na a headline that said something like the Kenya police in a need close to 106 billion for reforms. That's how much we need for police reforms, according to our president. And unashindwa, like, when you think about police reforms, what are we thinking about? We are thinking about things like just stopping police brutality. And apart from stopping police brutality, we are thinking of stopping extrajudicial killings, unajua. And just having a police force that's reasonable. So, yes, kuna vile on Wednesday, kulikuwa na headline ilikuwa Ruto government needs 106 billion to implement police reforms. So this is the interesting part. Then tukitoka hiyo part, of course, sasa tuna go back to vile nakwambia, on Wednesday he says that, and then on Thursday kukaenda kukiwa na ile ceremony ili happen State House ile Douglas Kanja was being installed as the new Inspector General.
I now call upon Mr. Douglas Kanja Kirosho for his installation into the rank of Inspector General of the National Police. Your Excellency, you will be assisted in the installation by the Cabinet Secretary for Interior and National Administration. Welcome.
So yes, umejione hapo. So Kanja akakuwa installed as the new Inspector General. But for me, I always look at Ruto as a very shrewd politician. And the fact that he's a very shrewd politician, he's someone who plans ahead. And yofikiria, antrai kuona vitu zinaendaje. So saizi, as he tries to secure 2027, ile kitu anasema he's not trying to secure, he's doing it in a few ways. Look at it, wacha tuangalia a few things that have happened. On June 25th, we had the mother of all protests. But then I think on June 27th, ndio nani azi, I think Rex Masai, I think alikuwa dedishwa tayari, alikuwa amededishwa on 20th, on 20th of June. So Ruto, the image of the guy who shot Rex Masai ikakuwa shared on social media. Was this guy ever arrested? No, he was not arrested. Ruto kafanya Twitter space. This Twitter space ilifanya watu kaenda kwa me hit Otero. And Otero aka bring up your story, Rex Masai aka bring up, like, unomsa lidedisha nani? Was that guy ever arrested? No. And then, fast forward, tukuje around July. Around July, you have to ask yourself, kwa nini ama ukarawa ku arrested? Because any cop who killed protesters lazima angaliwe kama, you know, like someone who is helping the government. So hivyo ni huyu ni mtu anasaidia gava, na gava hii kitu, like the protest were like, unajua Ruto alitwitaga criminals because he was really angry. He was not understanding, like mtadetaje na yeye mwenyewe alikuwa chosen by God directly, so he didn't understand that. So anyone who killed protesters that time was a hero. And that's why around July 24th, ile time alicheki makarao anadu his dirty work, alienda pa me wa promise like salary increase. Yeah. So was that kuimagine, like during that time bado ile flavor, ile fire ya protest bado ilikuwa. Yeah, so akambia sejo, mine nda ku increase salary zenyu. This was ile time alikuwa like July, alibaki wamewameet, akabaki wamewambia that nitawapatia higher salaries. Of course, now This was to make sure that wakienda kwa streets and they are being brutal with us, they can be totally brutal na sisi. Alafu sasa ukisikiza like part of Ruto's speech on Thursday, itakuonyesha why he knows he will need the police in 2027. Na cheki. So, unajua Ruto tuitaga protesters ana to classify gi as criminals. So, scale actually sema on Thursday.
I want to commit, as I have done in the past, that we will continue to look at the terms of service and also all other requirements of our security agencies, both human capital, welfare issues, the kind of tools and equipment they need to be able to efficiently keep our country safe and secure and protect us from criminals, crooks and terrorists.
Mechikio, criminals. Kumbuko mse, alikuwa naita protesters criminals. So now, we have to, vile nimesema, you have to look at Ruto and know that he's planning ahead. So, even before Thursday, you have to look at, like before Kanja, who was there? Masengeli. Masengeli ignored court orders na vitu kama hizo. Kumbuka when Ruto came into power, he said he was going to be the president who reminds us that Kenya is a country of laws. Sindio? Nakumbuka. Alisema that like on his inauguration speech a lot of times. Kenya is a country of laws. Kenya is a country of laws. But now, Masengeli ignores court orders. When Ruto is asked about it, he says that the different arms of government need to collaborate. Hiyo time akusema it's a country of laws, we need to follow court orders, we need haikuwa hivyo ilikuwa, tunanid kukooperate. So now Kanja akikamin, anakamin akijua, president amemfanyia favor by giving him this job and making sure I've nominated you and I've made sure that we've gotten the job. So what can we expect in 2027? In 2027, two things might happen. Kenyans might forget everything that happened in 2024, and end up voting for Ruto. Yes? Why? Because another thing is we don't know. We don't have an opposition. But another thing might happen. Something like happened like place kama Senegal where the opposition did not even campaign. But people were tired. And people ended up voting them. Also, kwa freed leo. Ma kesho kuna elections. Na wakashinda. Yo elections ya kesho. I think kwa freed ata usiku. Like leo usiku. But during the day, kuna elections and they ended up winning the elections. That can happen in Kenya. And if that was to happen, what would happen on the other side? The police would remember, you know what? This guy, he's the one who gave me this job. That's what Kanja would look at. Masengeli would look at it this way, like, what if one of these opposition guys ends up in power and now, he could order ile nilikuwa, no, I can end up going to jail. So the police will keep Ruto in power. So if he does not get it by the vote, like through wananchi, he'll keep power through the police. That's how I'm looking at it. Because otherwise, ukiangalia hizi stories zake anawa promise salary, apart from salary, wale wamekuwa caught, wakidedisha protesters, no one has been caught. Even during like Kibaki's time, during your time, a few cops were taken. Walipelekwa ndani juu ya stories za kudedisha share protesters. Nachiki. So, and Kibaki was doing the same thing, but not hakuifanya na yuma nga ya Ruto ile la iko nene. Unajua Ruto ni the iko nene president. So, ya nasema iko nene. Because makarau wendaga jela. Unajua, sometimes we forget that cops go to jail. Na kuna kama juzi, kuna uko media na nitwa Tainga Shira, alienda pa meshare, like there's this cop who was in jail. And of course, tukio naga karau, akiwa jela tunashinda kwa like what happened, how did this guy find himself here, and Tai ended up sharing the story that this guy had beat up an inmate, alibaki amemchapa na akamdrown basically kwa police station, and that's how the guy ended up in jail. So he was not like this innocent cop that the way he was trying to portray himself, like say fulani mu innocent kabisa. But yes, mimi ukiniuliza Ruto anajipanga and he's making sure that he has everything covered. So one thing is, I mean, his opposition box, and ajua endorsement ya someone like Raila who has like this, whatever, following, itamsaidia, because a lot of people atafuata blindly, so that's going to help his numbers. And if he's not able to keep the mountain 100%, he hopes that that can help him tilt to the other side. But if not that, he hopes that even kata shindwa gapi takuwa ndogo kabisa, na gapi kiwa ndogo, the police will handle the rest for him. Nani ataenda kuprotest? Unacheki. So umsa anaendelea kujipanga, but sasa swali ni as opposition tunajipangaje, as the so-called as wajenzi wanajipangaje? Unacheki tayari kulikuwa na fight nani, kulikuwa time kuna shina kisema we need a leader, I need a leader. Morara ashatokea, wakaanza kufight na udema anaitwa nani, Masita Rus. So that's happening. On the other side kuna mse kama Kasmuel amekuwa kimita ama politicians wa shady, so I don't know what's going to happen with that. So as things stand right now, if this guy has the police and he has the opposition, I see him staying here till 2032. And I even see a situation whereby people like akina Cherargei watakuwa as confident, yani walikuwa as confident as they were when this regime came into power ile time, kuna sema we need to change the constitution so that this guy can run the country forever. But yes, msana endelea kujipanga, na ni time yetu pia ya kuenda, tumejua that all these appointments, they are going to come at a price. Kanja being appointed is going to come at a price. And of course, Masengeli also not going to jail. He's going to be reminded every day, like, Buddha, I'm the reason why you are free. So 2027, mukidhubutu kuinua kichwa hivi, ndio mtakumbushwa vile nyinyi ni criminals. Because sahau, when it comes to protesting, Ruto knows, ama Ruto feels that anyone who protests against him is a criminal. Iko nene.